welcome to another live edition here on the Open Mic Broadcast Network, the Mike Prince Show, on site down in Houston, Texas. It is signing day 2019. I guess, yes, it's 2019. My goodness. Time sure does fly when you're having fun. People are gradually coming in on tonight's event. We will be covering. We have scheduled to speak with us Coach Eric Dooley, the Ghost, will be with us on today. Ted White and Coach Henry Miller were also supposed to be on. I believe it was Coach White or Miller who will not be able to make things happen on tonight. But with all that being said, we will be here in full blast, ready to take care of business. We got people coming in, getting ready to go. Got Brother Tim Thorne in on the house. It is signing day 2019. 25 young men signing up, ready to be a part of the PV Nation, and we're excited to have them on board. Before we get any further along with tonight's festivities, we want to remind you that today's episode, this special episode of the Mike Prince Show on location, is going to be presented to you by JZE Building and Restoration. They are, of course, located in the Cypress, Texas area, where they specialize in renovation, restoration, and flat-out new construction. They definitely have everything that you would need to take care of your building needs. You can give them a call today at 832-319-8477. Also, the good people from Attorney Lee Van Richardson's office, located at 1047 Austin Street in Hempstead, Texas. Whatever your legal matters are, Attorney Lee Van Richardson can accommodate you for whatever that need may be. Their phone number is 979-826-8008. Well, as things are shaping up and moving in and about, it is definitely exciting to be a part of the PV Nation splendor, if you would, as the Panthers under Coach Eric Dooley will be getting ready to introduce some of their signees, some big names, and we'll get a chance to try to talk to these individuals more or less about how they come about with their rosters and everything else that's going on. We're going to even possibly talk about the schedule that will be on hand for tonight. Right now, it's a 10-game schedule. They're allowed to play 12 games, but we'll see how that comes to be when we get a chance to speak with the athletic director. As we are here at the Prairie View Nursing Center, we want to remind you that the Mike Prince Show, which comes on each and every day at 10 a.m. Central Standard Time, giving you all the latest and the greatest of what's going on throughout the world of HBCU sports and beyond. Our social media handles for Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook are at the Mike Prince Show. The YouTube channel is Open Mic Broadcast Network. We are also available on the World Wide Web at obnradio.com, and we have a 24-hour dial-in message line, 713-570-6736. That number again is 713-570-6736. Call in, leave your thoughts, information, and even questions, comments, or concerns. We are here to receive it all. We've had people coming up. It is going to be a pretty nice turnout, it looks like, on tonight. Expecting over 200 people to be in the house. Right now, it is fully, slowly but surely, I should say, filling up. Everything is decked out with the black tabletops. We even got our black OBN sports tabletop as we're set up here in the corner section. You hear the live band playing in the background as everybody is getting acclimated and getting situated for tonight's festivities. Going to be an exciting night on tonight. Great expectations for the Panthers and Coach Dooley as they'll get ready for year two of the Dooley spot the ball era. Panthers went 5-6 under the first year of Coach Dooley. Got the big win over Grambling State, and everything else kind of tapered off after that. We'll get a chance to speak with Coach Dooley, find out exactly who, what, when, where, and how things are shaping up on that point. We do know that we have the non-conference schedule at least somewhat ready for this 2019 campaign. It has just recently been announced a couple of weeks ago that the Panthers will be taking on the likes of the University Cougars of U of H, University of Houston Cougars, and also will be taking on Nicholls State. And it has been whispered that a NAIA school or two, possibly to be the ones in conjunction for a homecoming festivity, whether it would be Texas College or Virginia Lynch or even possibly Langston, yet to be determined on who that opponent would be. Hopefully all that will be cleared up. We do know that the Panthers have had a big signing by a young man by the name of Ahmad Antone, running back out of New Orleans, had over 20 offers of being selected and offered up for his skills and services. He chose to become a Panther, and that is always a good thing. So we'll get a chance to see how he'll come out and work out in the midst of things for the likes of Coach Eric Dooley. We do know Coach Dooley has strong ties to the Louisiana, the state of Louisiana, and down in the Big Easy to get things situated and locked up. Speaking of getting things locked up, we are going to take us a break, and when we come back, we'll hopefully have our first guest lined up for tonight's festivities here from Houston, Texas. I am the radio guy, Mike Rest. We are going to take a quick break, and we will be right back. Keep it where you got it.
Hey, hey, my name is Nikki Antwine, owner of Miracles and Blessings Salon and Spa out in Missouri City, Texas. I want to shout out to my son, Andre Lewis, who is the receiver over at PV University. And I just want to say I love listening to Mike Prince on the Open Mic Broadcast Network.
One voice. It can get the point across, but it only carries so far. Add a voice. It's richer, louder, but that has limits too. Add a third voice. It's even more powerful. Add another, and many, many more, and we are stronger than ever. That's the power of a community coalition. They help community groups, faith groups, civic organizations, PTAs, employers, and many others in your community organize their resources and focus them where they're needed most, like fighting to keep kids away from drugs. Ask a group that you belong to if they should belong to a community coalition. It's easy to get involved. Visit helpyourcommunity.org and they'll tell you exactly how your group can help. That's helpyourcommunity.org, because you get more when you get together. Brought to you by the Office of National Drug Control Policy and the Ad Council.
Be the one with courage to fight child abuse.
All Texans must find the courage to fight child abuse.
Learn the signs and symptoms and report suspected abuse to appropriate authorities.
Learn and know these warning signs.
A child who undergoes changes in behavior, appetite, or routine. Watch for unexplained injuries, a change in academic performance, or loss of interest by a child in regular activity.
Trust your instincts. If you suspect something, do something.
If you believe a child is in an abusive situation, please call the Texas Abuse Hotline at 1-800-252-5400.
Be the one with courage. To find your local Children's Advocacy Center, visit onewithcourage.org.
On behalf of children, thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
This is Patricia Baer, president of JDE Building and Restoration. We specialize in full roof replacement and roof leaks. We assist homeowners with filing insurance claims and help you with the full process from start to finish. We are a complete remodeling and rehab company for commercial and residential. We do drywall, electrical, plumbing, HVAC, flooring, fencing, paint, framing, and much more. He can handle any job, small or large. Contact information is 832-319-8477, JZE Building and Restoration.
And welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, the radio guy, Dr. Mike Prince. We are live back in Houston, Texas. It is signing day 2019, and our first guest to join us today will be offensive coordinator, Coach Ted White. How you doing, Coach?
I'm doing okay. How are you?
Man, I'm doing better than okay, man. This is a good thing, a good event. You guys have been busy on the grind. And let me first give you a proper introduction from the Open Mic Broadcast Network. As old Sam said, it took a long time, but we got you here, man, and welcome to the show.
Thank you so much, man. I heard you guys a lot on the radio and just glad and happy that I'm able to be here.
Oh, well, we're happy to have you here. Now, if you don't mind, Coach, for those of us, you'd be amazed. A lot of people say, man, I don't even know what you guys sound like. So if you don't mind, introduce yourself and a little bit of your background, and then we'll go on from there.
I'm from Baton Rouge, Louisiana. I'm with the Glen Oaks High School.
Okay.
From Glen Oaks High School, I ended up sending to Howard University in Washington, D.C.
Oh, Bison.
Yeah, Bison. So I played quarterback at Howard University for 4 years. Had an opportunity to go to the National Football League, play for the Kansas City Chiefs 2 years.
Uh-huh.
Played for the Tampa Bay Buccaneers 2 years up under Tony Dungy.
Yes, sir.
Got an opportunity to play for the Jacksonville Jaguars up under Tom Coughlin. And got an opportunity to play in the Canadian Football League with the Montreal Alouettes for 2 years. After that, had my first job. My first job was at Texas Southern University, so I know that's a bad
thing. I said, we'll forgive you on that one, but that's okay. Go ahead.
My first job was at Texas Southern University up under Steve Wilson.
Uh-huh.
Learned a lot from him, which was my old coach at Howard University. Then I had an opportunity to go to Southern University. That's where I got a chance to work with Coach Dooley. Coach Dooley was the wide receiver coach, and I was the quarterback coach up under Stomp Mitchell.
He played with the St. Louis Cardinals. I'm from St. Louis. He used to come by old high school, Vashon High School, all the time. I know he's a Southern man, but, you know, go ahead. I didn't mean to cut you off.
No, you're okay. You know, Stomp is a good guy, and we got an opportunity to work together at Southern University. I stayed there 1 year as a quarterback coach, and I had an opportunity to go back to my alma mater at Howard University and be the offensive coordinator quarterback coach. So myself and Coach Dooley always kept in touch. Our families are really close. My daughter's really close with his daughter. My wife is really close with his wife. And we always talk strategies. We always had an opportunity to talk in the off season. And, we got an opportunity to work with each other here at Prairie A&M. And it's been a blessing so far. Coach Dooley is a man of God. He is a championship guy and a mold of men. And look forward to working with him in the future and bring a championship to Prairie A&M.
Yes, sir. Now that we get caught up to the 2018 season, a bunch of highs and lows to get started off. I think the great, I guess, waiting to exhale in the moment for PV Nation was finally getting over that gremlin hump.
Yeah.
And then it was a kind of hot and cold, mixing and matching quarterbacks trying to fit the schemes. To be quite honest with you, it was really a year of getting to know you from both a coaching staff and a players. Would that be safe to assume?
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. We're all coming from different places. We got an opportunity to work with this Prairie View team, and we did have some ups and we did have some downs. You know, it was a really good chance for us to be able to beat a good Grambling team where Coach Zula came from. But after we beat that Grambling team, we really didn't know how to handle success.
Uh-huh.
And, we took a couple bumps in the road against Southern University and Auntwan at homecoming, as well as Jackson State on the road. And then we started to gain momentum again against Alabama State and Texas Southern. So hopefully, the guys that's coming back, we get an opportunity to build off what we did last year and get an opportunity to start again versus the team that we ended it off with Texas Southern and be able to play them on August the 31st and do a really good job and get a win for the PV Nation.
Absolutely. Now, Coach, everybody has, as they call it, growing pains and an aha moment.
Uh-huh.
What was your aha moment being offense coordinator for Prairie View on the last season?
I would say the homecoming game against Auburn. We had just come off a terrible game against Southern University. And, just being able to be here at home for our second game, and then we didn't get an opportunity to win that game. And let me put one before that. Also, Southern University.
Oh, I was going to say, I was about to bring that.
Also, Southern University, which is our home game, because I'm from Baton Rouge, Louisiana.
Uh-huh.
So, that was a tough pill to swallow. But, hopefully we learn from that. We had some young kids that made some terrible mistakes. And, I thought I could have, before I put it on the kid, I would put it on myself to do a better job and make sure that we're able to capitalize on some of the things that we messed up on. And, you know, hopefully we learn from that experience and we get an opportunity to bounce back from when we come to Baton Rouge, Louisiana, and play them.
Yes, sir. Now, let me give you a brief background. Now, I've been in Prairie for 30-plus years. I'm an old swag baseball player. I was all-conference baseball player, all-academic, president team, all that good stuff.
Yeah.
And I live in Prairie.
Okay.
So it's near and dear to me.
Yes, sir.
Would it be safe to assume that one of the challenges was for us to adjust in the middle of the game, not necessarily in between games, but on the fly?
Yeah, that would be, you know, a good assessment, you know, but – you know, as offensive coordinator, there's always some things that you want to take back after you watch the film. Say, oh, man, I thought I should have did this.
Uh-huh,
you know,
uh-huh.
I should have did this to get put us in a better situation to be successful to put some points on the board. And, you know, we got some great football minds in the room. You know, we got Coach Dooley. We got myself. We got Coach Mark Frederick, which is our running back coach. We got Coach Jonathan Williams. We got Coach Ashton Williams, which is our offensive line coach. And all of these guys are coming from different locations, but they're great people. And it's all kind of minds, all kind of football minds in the room. So, yes, we probably could have done a better job for us adjusting in the game, but it was a mistake that we shouldn't have made that game. And,
right.
You know, as players, you know, you got to learn from it and we got to be able to move
on. And that's as a competitor.
Yeah.
You want to always go back. Even when you have a successful play, that was something that could have been done
exactly.
A little bit better to maximize that thing.
Exactly.
Now, I'm an old defensive guy. I'm an old linebacker myself. I know you're quarterback, offensive minded, and all that. But I really believe, and I know you understand this being an old quarterback, the games are won and lost in between the trenches.
Oh, absolutely.
Okay. With this being signing day, and I know everybody, we're excited about young Ahmad, who decided to become a Panther, and Shane Lawrence is going to become. What are we doing to protect these skill position players? What have we done in this signing?
So we got Garrett Walton. Garrett Walton is a kid that's from Memphis, Tennessee, which we signed a kid from there the previous year, Josh Crawford. But Garrett Walton is a 6'3", 295 guard, all right, that does a tremendous job opening the holes for running backs and quarterbacks. He's a well-built kid. He's a power lifter, but he understands the football game. All right, Bartney is a kid that we're getting May, all right, that's signed for us. He's a junior college kid that's really going to be able to help us in the trenches, all right? We know we lost Jamal Fontenot last year, all right, so he'll be able to come in and help us at that top position.
Yes, sir. We're talking right now with offensive coordinator Ted White. We got some good jazz playing behind
us. Oh, absolutely.
You know, the music is great. The atmosphere is great. Coach, this is really you guys' full year.
Yeah.
Being acclimated into the quote-unquote PV way.
Right.
What are you learning as you get acclimated into this environment?
Well, one thing that I've learned about Prairie View is that, man, there's so many nice people in Prairie View. Before I got here, I was so naive about Prairie View. I didn't know Prairie View had as many things as they had, such as a nice stadium, such as a nice gym, such as a nice recreation center. Also, they have great students there. They had an opportunity to do some really good things and go out of society and be some really good citizens in this world. And, you know, I was naive to the fact because it was my first time actually in Fairview. But I got an opportunity to be here for a year. I love it. My wife loves it because I stay right across the street from my outlet mall.
Hold on to your wallet, man. Hold on to your wallet.
She kills my pocket, you know. So, you know, it's really good people. I think we have a really good coaching staff. Most of all, I think we have really good kids that are eager to learn, that are not satisfied, and they're really good competitors to try to get better in their task and making sure that they get better in their craft.
Okay. Now, Coach, competition brings out the best or the worst in all of us, depending on how people rise up to the occasion. You got five quarterbacks coming into the spring, man. That's a lot of quarterbacks. You have enough balls for that?
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely, man. And one thing that we wanted to do is make the room more competitive. Not
uh-huh.
just the quarterback room, but make the whole team more competitive. So if you play quarterback position and I play the quarterback position, and we're going to push each other to get better. All right, and that's what it's all about. So if we push each other to get better, all right, I think all of us will get better in the room, okay? And that's what we wanted to try to create, just some competitive juices in the room. Obviously, we got Jalen Martin, he played last year and played really good in spurts. You know, he talked about the games that he didn't play so well in. But, you know, as a quarterback, you always chomping at the bit and want to get back into the game and kind of prove yourself again. We got Trayzon Conley, a kid from Duncanville, Texas. Did some really good things for us, okay? And we had an opportunity to redshirt him also. we had an opportunity to get acclimated to college football. We got Nico Holland, okay, a kid that didn't play with us last year, but he's chomping at the bit because he has an opportunity to really get strapped up again this year. We got T.J. Starks, the kid that's a transfer from Kansas. He went to Iowa Western, and he's enrolled in school right now, and he's doing a really good job of getting acclimated, working out and getting around the kids, and those guys are throwing every day. And we got Desmond Hunter. Desmond Hunter is a kid, is a junior college kid from Woodville, Mississippi. Played a couple plays last year, but he is a good player, very high IQ. And I'm satisfied with the guys that I have right now because they're going to do a good job for me.
Well, you always got in the hole, too, man. Old Tristan Wallace was an old quarterback. I was looking for you to call a jet sweep and let him pass something on the backside to Holcomb hitting a post pattern, but I never did see that, man. But do you ever play around with him in practice, you know, with your quarterback?
You know what, we had a couple of double passes in practice, and they worked. And we try to do it in the game. We try to do it against University of Arkansas, Pine Bluff, and we try to do it against Grambling. It didn't work neither time, so we got to be able to put him back there and definitely get the ball to that guy. He's a special guy.
Yeah.
He's a special guy. We're so blessed to have him, man, because – there were so many opportunities that he could have went to other institutions, but he gave us the opportunity to really come here. Kid is from the Dallas area. He's from DeSoto High School, a very historic high school. He played quarterback. That was a five-star athlete. So he's got two more years with us. So, you know, hopefully he's going to rewrite all the record books here at Prairie View and everywhere else.
Okay, Coach Ted White, man, it has been an honor, man, and a joy to finally get a chance to meet with you and talk. I'm going to give you some final thoughts and comments as we customarily do with all our guests.
Okay.
And the floor is now yours.
Thank you so much for having me on here. Like I said, we're very happy to be here. This is our second time here at the Recruiting Bash, and you guys have always done a great job. Again, I love being in Prairie View. Look for us next year to do some great things.
All right. Looking to do some great things. We are going to take us a break here momentarily, and we'll come back and we'll get a chance to hear from the Ghost himself, Coach Eric Dooley. And the son. Now, if I'm understanding, Coach Miller was not going to be able to make it tonight, right?
From what I don't know.
Okay, I think it was Coach Miller that's not going to be able. But man, we want to thank you. Know you got an open door here at the Open Mic Broadcast Network, man, and we look forward to having many more conversations.
Thank
with
you so much, Mr. Brent.
All right, thank you, man. Call me Mike, man. Call me Mike.
All right, Mike.
All right. Coach Ted White, offensive coordinator for the Prairie View A&M University Panthers. We are going to take us a break. And we'll try to track down our next visitor here live from the PV Nursing Center in Prairie View, Texas. Keep it where you got it, ladies and gentlemen, and we'll be right back. You listen to the Open Mic Broadcast Network.
How you doing? It's the radio guy, the Dr. Mike Prince, reminding you that you're listening to the Open Mic Broadcast Network. We're taking a break from our live coverage right now. However, we'd like to remind you that we bring a lot more to the table than you may be aware of. Did you know about Our Journey Alive? It's a weekly talk show that features three dynamic women sharing their overcoming of domestic abuse and much, much more. You can listen to Sophia and the Gang each and every week right here at the Open Mic Broadcast Network. What about Prairie View United, also known as PVU? It's giving you up-to-date information going on throughout the city limits of Prairie View, Texas, and Waller County, Texas. Of course, there is the sports report that is breaking news of the world of athletics and the daily Mike Prince coverage of the Mike Prince Show right here at the Open Mic Broadcast Network. And for those who seek spiritual guidance, we even offer Sunday Morning Live, live broadcast of the Temple of Refuge Ministries, brought to you each and every week right here on the Open Mic Broadcast Network. So be sure to check out what you've been missing by visiting the website at obnradio.com, or you can dial 605-477-5066. And for those who happen to be within the Prairie View community, you can always check us out at 87.9 FM, the station designed with you in mind, serving the community through faith and athletics, the Open Mic Broadcast Network.
Reach more potential customers through our sports radio package by dialing 832-213-8824.
And welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. We are live from Houston, Texas, the Prairie View A&M University Nursing Center. The radio guy, Dr. Mike Prince. I have a ghost sighting. We got Coach Eric Dooley. How you doing, Coach?
I'm doing well. How are you?
All right. Well, Happy New Year to you, first of all, man. And as always, you're looking dapper Dan.
Thank you. Thank you.
It must be the new thing, huh?
Yeah, it is.
Well, look, Coach, this is your second go-around, but this time you had a little bit more planning ahead. What's the difference between this year's recruiting and last year's recruiting?
Well, you know, it really wasn't much of a difference, just the time factor. You know, I'm aggressive when it comes down to recruiting, so the same mindset that we had coming in last year with a short period of time was the same mindset here, because, you know, guys don't last long, so you have to go out and get those guys and have that mindset that you got to bring them to the place. And our biggest thing is we got to be able to tell our own story. Once we get them to campus, then we can tell our story. Because, you know, so many guys, they hear about Prairie View, but they never came. So once we get them here, then they understand that the family affair that's here, that the whole commitment throughout the whole university.
Yes, sir. Now, we spoke with Ted White, offensive coordinator, and he was saying there were so many surprises that he learned being on the staff. So you can imagine what a student athlete may have heard or might not be aware of and what Prairie View has to offer. Now, everything is moving fast, and they tell me, man, you got the gift of gab. You can talk a possum out of a tree. You pulled a young man out of New Orleans who had 20 offers, a lot of them FBS, Ahmad. Tell us about this young man and some of the other recruits that you pulled in on this go-around.
Oh, man, we was excited to be able to have an opportunity to talk to him. See, my philosophy is it doesn't matter who's recruiting him. I just need an opportunity to sit down and talk with him and tell them about our university, tell them about our coaching staff, tell them about the university staff. And I think we, you know, by the grace of God, it gave us the opportunity to go in there and talk with that young man. And his parents and himself came up to a visit, and it was highly impressed. More than not just about the facilities, which was great, but the academic piece that we displayed to those individuals. So it gave us a great opportunity to get a quality young man that not only is he a good football player, but he's good in his books as well. And, you know, we had an opportunity to go across a lot of different states. Of course, we stayed in Texas and got some key guys out of Texas. And we had an opportunity to go to Mississippi as well as Louisiana. So we ventured into a lot of different places. And when I take a look at Prairie View A&M University, you know, I do understand the rich tradition here at Texas, and I'm going to always recruit the backyard. But when you look at the story that Prairie View can tell, that the vision that Dr. Root has, you've got to be able to go nationwide and recruit, and we feel that we can go to war with anyone when it comes down to recruiting.
Absolutely. Now, you just brought up a very key point. A lot of people that are listening to this and that are probably listening to it on the podcast version of it, a lot of people get the notion that it should be Texas, 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 Texas. I'm all for that, and I understand that. I want people who can come in and that's going to feel the need that I have and can be productive. And on the flip side, in all fairness to you and your staff, people don't realize that sometimes it's hard to get through the Texas high school doors if you don't have a Texas connection. Is that true, sir?
Well, you know what? You can say that's the case, but my thing is I'm going to go out. I had an opportunity to go to a lot of high schools here in Cypress, Texas, in Houston area, in Dallas, Texas, in San Antonio, in Austin, and I just want to talk to the coaches. It doesn't matter to me. It doesn't matter who the player is. It doesn't matter where they come from or what they say can't happen. I feel and believe that, you know, God sent me here for a reason. So
uh-huh.
It's not going to be a door that I'm not going to be able to knock on and get in.
Yes, sir. Now, we're talking right now with Coach Eric Dooley, head football coach of the Prairie View A&M University Panthers. What is a different Dooley 2019 versus Dooley of 2018?
Well, you know, the different Dooley right now, I hate to say it in a way that I'm not accustomed to, and I'm never going to become accustomed to. I'm not used to finishing second or third, and that's a mindset for me that has to change. I'm very pleased with the young men, the way that they are working, and the mindset and the attitude. I'm not only just on the football field, but in the classroom as well. So my mindset now is I got a year up under my belt. I made an assessment, which I don't wait time to make an assessment. You got to go to work right now because, you know, you don't have 10 years to get things done. You got to get it done right now. I believe in the microwave, so I look for it right now. But, you know, I think I'm I won't say I'm wiser because I've been in this conference for a long time. I've seen a lot of different things, and some things I see the growth of it. But I feel real confident in what we got coming back and with the kids understanding what we're trying to present to them.
Yes, sir. When we spoke with Coach White on the last segment, he said one of the things that he wanted to see was him possibly making some better selections during the course of the game and more or less adjusting during the game than in between games. Is that a safe assessment to walk with?
That is assessment. That's the way I've always carried myself, and we'll get into those different things like that. I don't believe in waiting to have time to make an assessment to come out with a bang. I believe you got to make that assessment right now. You got to make those changes, those game changes, because you know you got so many different mood swings in a change in a game. So you want to be aggressive in everything that you do. But we looked at a lot of film and looked at our whole last year, and I'm a little upset because I know what should have taken place. But nevertheless, we know what we have to do. Now we just got to roll up our sleeves and go back to work.
Yes, sir. Coach, another thing is the schedule. Is this schedule going to be it, or are there going to be a couple more games added? What's the prognosis on the schedule?
Right now, of course, you always look for another game or two if you can fill a void to get those guys to come to our home place because we want our fans to be able to stay at home and come to a home game. But right now, it's pretty much almost completed, and we feel real good about it.
Okay, now I do understand it was Nicholls State, University of Houston. Did we ever determine on who the homecoming opponent would be?
No, I think Mr. Washington is working that out right now, and he's probably going to be the one to unveil that to you guys later on.
Okay, later on today or later on like later on?
No. Well, it's going to be one of those later on.
Coach Eric Dooley, head football coach of the Prairie View A&M University Panthers. The brother has on this dapper. If I lean up against him, I might get a close shave on me over here, man. Did you bring your family with you tonight?
Yes, my wife and my younger daughter is with me right here. My other daughter is still at work, so she's going to try to make it over. But I'm pleased because last year it was just me and my middle daughter here. But
right.
Now I got my family, and I'm a lot at ease now.
Well, hey, man, it makes life a little bit easier to deal with.
A whole lot easier.
Well, Coach, I hope this won't be the last time that we get a chance to chit-chat with you. Like I told Coach White, you are always welcome here at the Open Mic Broadcast Network. We are right there in the community with you guys. I've been a season ticket holder, been a product of Prairie View. I live in the community, so we look forward to some growth and getting some wins done. Not only do we need to beat Grambling, but we need to find a way to beat Southern, Alcorn, whoever else they put in front of us this time around.
Whatever game is on the schedule, that's the ones we need to win.
Yes, sir. Coach Dooley, I want to give you some final thoughts and comments as we get ready to wrap this segment up, sir.
Well, you know, I'm looking forward to this year coming. Our kids are working hard right now as we speak. They came the very first day of class. They started winter conditioning. Our strength and conditioning coach does a fine job with those young men. But more than that, we got those guys off in class, and they understand the magnitude of the whole picture. So I'm ready, and we're just ready to get these practices underway and continue to see what we're going to put on display this upcoming season.
Do you have the dates for your spring practice yet?
We're going to start our official spring practice. It's going to start March 25th will be the first spring practice.
March 25th.
March 25th.
We have the purple and gold game.
The purple and gold game is going to be April the 18th, which is a Thursday night at 6 p.m.
So, you know what, Coach? I just had something come up, and I got to ask this. Uniform, we have some issues with uniforms. Are we addressing that right now?
It's been addressed, and it's the sad thing about the whole situation. Those uniforms was addressed at the early part of the year before we even ordered. Our equipment manager sent the information to the NCAA as well as to the offices to get a clearance, and we did get that clearance. But for whatever reason, they made us change. But you know what? Sometimes it happens like that. We just deal with it and keep moving on.
Okay. Now, are they going to address possibly to eliminate all that, just probably going to more of a basic uniform or like an example of the gold and anything like that? Or are they going to keep things as are?
Well, here's the thing what I did do. You know, you talk about those adjustments during the game.
Uh-huh.
I made adjustments during the season. Those uniforms has been changed, and we're ready to go.
So you can give us a peek of what it might be like, Coach?
I think you might have to wait to just play. My equipment manager don't like me to say some things, but we're going to have a couple of surprises. I can tell you that right now.
Okay. Well, we really appreciate it very much, sir. Go in there. Don't let your penny get cold, man. Coach Eric Dooley, head football coach of the Prairie View A&M University Panthers. Panthers getting locked and loaded and ready for the 2019 campaign. A very good turnout here on this evening as the band is playing and doing this thing. We are going to take us yet another break, and we'll come right back with more live coverage right here from Houston, Texas, and the Open Mic Broadcast Network live coverage of the 2019 signing day. We'll be right back.
Chris, can you put the video game controller down for a second?
I can talk and play.
Oh,
I'm totally annihilating this punk kid in Nebraska.
I just feel like you're not acting like a grown-up in our relationship.
M2!
Well, you know, you still ride your skateboard to work, there's the comic book collection, the race car bed.
Look, I'm young at heart, but I put money into my 401k every paycheck. I picked up a few savings tips at feedthepig.org. I have control over my financial life now, and that feels pretty grown up.
I put away a few bucks, feel like $1 million. Putting some money from every paycheck into a savings account or contributing to your 401k can make a big difference later. For free ideas and easy tips on ways to save, go to feedthepig.org. That's feedthepig.org.
So, I better look like a grown-up to you now.
Well, except for the footy pajamas, I'd have to agree.
This message brought to you by the American Institute of Certified Public Accountants and the Ad Council.
Broadcasters come into our lives on radio and TV, bringing us information and entertainment. Broadcasters are there for us, but who is there for them when they fall on hard times? The Broadcasters Foundation of America provides financial assistance to broadcasters in acute need due to a critical illness, accident, or other serious misfortune. If you know of a broadcaster on the air or behind the scenes who may need our help, please share our message. Visit BroadcastersFoundation.org.
And welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. The radio guy, Dr. Mike Prince. We are live from Houston, Texas, as we are getting ready now. We're going to play a clip that we were able to catch up with Coach Sandy Pugh. As you know, we are right in the middle of basketball season. Big game on this weekend. The Lady Panthers will be taking on the Lady Tigers at Texas Southern beginning at 5:30. Panthers coming in at 7-2, tied for first with the Southern Lady Jags at 7-2. On the men's side, Panthers with a 10-game winning streak, 9 SWAC wins in a row. They'll be putting their undefeated conference record at stake with the Texas Southern Tigers beginning on Saturday night. We were able to catch up with Coach Sandy Pugh and get her feedback and assessment of the strong play that these young ladies had against Alabama State and the preparations for this week's opponent, the Lady Tigers.
How you doing, ladies and gentlemen? The radio guy, Dr. Mike Prince. An extremely busy week for Prairie View Athletics. Of course, it's National Signing Day this week, but we are in the middle of the beginning of the start of the second half for the basketball season. Panthers women program 7-2 on top of the Southwestern Athletic Conference in a tie, but we're going to say on top right now because mathematically they're on top of Southern, and they'll take care of that later on down the road. But first things first, big rival game coming up against the Texas Southern Tigers. We have with us Coach Sandy Pugh. Coach, how you doing today?
Hey, Mike, doing great.
Well, look, always good to have you, and thank you so much for making yourself available for us here on the show. Big things going on this week, a big rival week. You guys are in a good position right now, another critical game. But first, go back. You were able to take care of a good, strong competitor, Coach Frieda, at Alabama State. That was a critical game for you guys, and you showed up in a big way.
Yeah, the kids really came out with a lot of energy, changed up the lineup a little bit, get a little more speed, and I thought that really worked out for us. She has an extremely athletic team, good size. They matched up really well with us. You know, I just thought we did a good job of jumping out on them early, and the defensive intensity that we played with did a good job. Yeah, did a good job. The board, getting rebounds and getting out in transition and taking the ball to the hole. And we had a couple of hiccups there in the third where we kind of let them get back into the game. We had an opportunity to really stretch out our lead. But all in all, it was overall a solid team effort.
Absolutely. And then once again, it's always encouraging when you have a player or two who's been showing consistency, but you've been having that three-headed monster of late when I speak of Dobbins, Ford, and, of course, Newman. And beginning to gel, it appears, at the right time in a very critical game coming up against Texas Southern this week, which it was clearly that the three wasn't on the same page just of yet.
Well, the Texas Southern game, the kids are really excited about playing in it. They felt like they just really dropped the ball. You know, there was a lot of energy going on. I thought the kids were kind of we were sitting back. We were a little too conservative. We didn't come out with the energy and the fire that I knew we were capable of playing, and really disappointed with that overall effort. That next game, we came out with that fire and that energy that we needed, and we're progressing. You know, most coaches will tell you this time of the year, you want to continue to progress, you want to continue to play with, you know, that energy and that teamwork concept. But most importantly, you don't want to have peaked yet. You know, but I can see it coming, and as we go into the second round of the conference. It's going to be important that we continue to clean up a few little minor details like the box out on the weak side. I thought we gave up way too many of those the other night. Picked up a couple of ticky-tack fouls on the slash to the basket, and our rotations weren't as solid as I would like to be, but I think we cleaned up a couple of those aspects, and and the shot selection out of the break, I think we'll be fine.
We're speaking right now with Coach Sandy Pugh of the Prairie View A&M University Panthers women's basketball team. Coach, going back, we all have critics for positive and for negative energy for whatever that is. That's just the nature of life. Going back to your Southern coaching days and leading now to Prairie View, some of your critics will say a common denominator has been that it's always been a challenge for you to figure out how to beat Texas Southern. What's your response to that?
A challenge to beat. Well, Texas Southern has been an outstanding program over the last 6 or 7 years. Since Cooper took over there, they've really stepped their game up, in terms of their recruiting and what they're doing as a program coach. Coach Perry does a great job, and I have nothing but respect for that program. Anytime you can contend for a championship, you're a pretty good team. I don't care what level you're playing at. So, and here in our conference, that's been a very storied battle. We've had some literally knockdown and drag out.
Oh yeah, I'm thinking of a couple of not only regular season but tournament play where really literally there had to be some separation between your squads and those squads, and if the trend seemed to be carrying over even at TV Nation.
Well, trust me, and I talk to Coach Perry every week, but it's just a mutual respect of competitors, who are extremely competitive, who love to win, who enjoy and embrace the competition. It's nothing more than that. It isn't personal at all.
Oh, no. And you know what?
It's just strictly kids who want to be successful for their teams or program. From the TV perspective and my team and where I am right now, the kids just feel like they have something to prove. They feel like they let the student body down. They let the alumni base down when we, didn't handle the business over here. So they're eager to be on that court Saturday at 5:30, and we were asking for the nation to come out and support our student athletes. Our men are 9-0 and on a historic run. And it's just an exciting time for TV basketball all the way around. We're tied in first place. And we want to maintain that.
Absolutely.
We want to catch some of that magic dust going down this back stretch. and go 9-0 and go ahead and run the table. I mean, that's what we want to do. But it's gonna require Herculean effort on our part. It starts, you know. I used to always say the championships always go through Baton Rouge. I think, you know, by that same token, the championship's gonna go through Texas, and we have to go down to downtown Houston and handle some business Saturday. We need all the help we can get from our fan base.
Absolutely. Handling business is definitely what it's been all about. And let me tell you something, Coach. This is what I absolutely adore about you and Coach Byron Smith. It is almost like a blue-collar approach, the way you've built your teams and built your programs. I asked Coach Smith this. I'm going to ask you this. I'm an astute guy. I'm there when you don't think I'm there. But you know what I really love is how you guys dress on game day. And I want to ask you, as I've asked any other basketball coach, where was the memo sent out that you must put on your quote-unquote Sunday best when coaching basketball?
You know what? I don't know. You know, I guess to each his own. You know, when I first started as a newbie coach, you know, I learned fairly quickly that training bill gets really expensive. When you start talking about Sunday best. So, you know, and with the staff that I have here and, you know, they wanted to do something a little bit different. So I guess it's just to each his own.
To each his own. Well, I happen to love it. I've always thought, especially in basketball, I can see if the head coach has on a different color polo than the rest of the staff, you can identify who's who. But I've always scratched my head about that. Even football coaches wear khakis and whatever their uniform is, you know, the uniform or the university they're representing. But basketball coaches are unique breeds and creatures of habit, I guess. And I guess it's just if you look good, you feel good syndrome.
I guess that's how they go. You know, that's probably a good analysis.
But if you're winning, you look good in whatever you're wearing. Well, look, Coach, the first round against Texas Southern, you learned some things. You said the team came out a bit apprehensive. What are you telling the young ladies right now as they prepare for this week's battle?
Well, the whole thing right now is, you know, we're here. This is where we want to be. You know, we're first. This is, you know, we understand the challenge ahead of us. We understand the mistakes we made behind us. We want to continue to grow, and continue to get better defensively, continue to play as a unit. You know, to me, one of the greatest things I saw as you were talking about us playing together and the growth and development of the team with Dobbins and Newman and Ford is, you know, Shayla threw an alley-oop to Ford the other night, and the crowd went crazy, you know, because I'm going to tell you right now, I've watched every practice. She's never made that pass in practice. So, it was just one of those instinctual things. She saw it, boy, when he got it, and then it was beautiful. So, and it's the celebration between those two. So that was a beautiful thing to watch. And definitely something I'm excited to see.
It was one of them. It was one of them where you go, no, yes, all right, good job.
Yeah, it was kind of funny because I was talking to my assistant and I just happened to look up and the ball was in the air and I was like, oh. And then Artie, when he got it, it was a perfect pass. Oh.
That's all right. That's all right, man. It's a beautiful thing. What I've always appreciated about women's basketball is that they're more base-oriented teams, and they have to rely on the technique of boxing out, the technique of solid passing, and looking for teamwork to get that open shot. Things are shaping up, building up, exciting time, rival week, and a lot of buzzing going around the air. I want to personally thank you for always making yourself available from day one since coming to the Heel, and we look forward to the continued growth and the moving forward. This Saturday, the Panthers will be on foreign soil to take on Texas Southern. Tip-off time beginning at 5:30. Panthers 7-2, trying to separate themselves at the top of the Southwestern Athletic Conference. Coach, your final thoughts and comments on this segment.
Hey, again, Mike, I really appreciate you for giving us an opportunity to be on. We're looking forward to a big game Saturday and a win. So we're going down there to try to get this business handled. So I hope everybody out there comes out and supports your Panthers. Let's go.
Let's go. Coach Sandy Pugh, Panthers, ready to do battle this coming weekend. I am the radio guy, Dr. Mike Prince. As always, you guys be blessed. We'll see you on the other side.
And, of course, that was Coach Sandy Pugh with the 7-2 Panthers getting ready for Texas Southern this weekend. We have a defensive coordinator sighting. We're going to take a quick 30-second break, and we'll be right back with more of our live coverage. The Mike Prince Show on the road. We'll be right back.
Come on, hustle, 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 hustle. Get your head in the game. Come on.
Are you setting the right example for your kids?
You need to get some confidence.
Before your child's next game, ask yourself, how would you like it if they copied your behavior? Ad revenue has declined 15%.
Come on, kid, get some confidence.
Positive Coaching Alliance has valuable tips and tools to help our kids perform their best while keeping sports enjoyable for everyone. Positive Coaching Alliance, creating better athletes, better people.
And welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. The radio guy, Dr. Mike Prince, here with you live on the campus of Prairie View A&M University Nursing Center. I got me a little feedback here. We're going to fix that right now. There we go. We got that. We have now Coach Henry Miller. How you doing, Coach?
I'm good.
All right. Well, they say the party is officially started now that you've made it, right?
That's what they're saying. Now that I'm here, you can let the party start.
Well, look, we know you had some prior engagements. This is a busy, busy time for you. Just like I've done with Coach Ted White, let me first officially introduce you to the Open Mic Broadcast Network family and our listeners from abroad. Welcome to the show. Glad to have you. If you don't mind, man, give us a simple introductory of yourself, and then we'll go right into it from there.
Okay, sure. My name is Henry Miller. I'm from New Orleans, Louisiana. I've been coaching nearly over 20 years. I coached at several swag schools where I won championships at several swag schools until I came here. And, of course, our mission is to win a swag championship here.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. And with that pedigree that you bring into the table, you come in, you inherit a team that you got to kind of try as quickly as possible to put your signature on that, which can be fair and unfair at the same time. What was it like for you getting back in the saddle, inheriting the team that you inherited?
Well, the first thing, is exactly what you said. Those kids was my kids. So I had to try to figure a way, how can I use those kids so we can be successful? And I think that, me and my defensive staff did a great job of putting guys in position and wind up having a great defense, a decent defense, I should say.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. And with that, I'm an old defensive guy. So if I'm going to be critical, it's going to be on that side of the ball.
That's
because
right.
They say offense sell tickets, but defense is what makes you become a champion.
That's true.
And what I saw, and you're way more into it than I am, our guys just didn't have any juice toward the second half, toward the finish line.
Yeah.
And I don't know if that was because of lack of depth or inexperience at depth. Our guys appear to be cat-like fast, but not lion-like built strong for the duration.
Yes. And you're correct. It was both. It was depth and it was conditioning, And this year, that's what we're trying to fix. We know that strength is in numbers, so we're trying to get more guys that can play good football.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Now, with that being said, college, you get somewhat of a say-so. You get to recruit guys that you think would fit your program, and then some cases it's a hit, some cases it's a miss. This is my theory, and you can correct me at any time. You're the expert. I'm just a talk show host. I believe that SWAC, MEAC, HBCU programs are going to get what I call a three-tier ball player versus that five-tier, four-five-tier. And in most cases, we're going to get a lot of twos and ones, so we got to add more seasoning to the pot to kind of make it stretch out. Is that a safe assumption?
Yes, that's definitely a safe assumption. The guys we get, we're going to have to teach them. We're going to have to put some work into them, you know. They're not going to be already made, you know. But if they are, then they've gone to those state colleges. But every now and then, we get up a nice one, you know. And I think this year in our recruiting class, we got a few freshmen that can probably step in and play this year.
Well, that's always a good sign that if you can get a freshman that can come in and be an impact player, and it also lets you know what you had to work with to begin with. Now, does that become frustrating being in your position?
Well, it teaches you patience. You know, it's not frustrating, but patience. You have to have a lot of patience because you want things to happen now, and they're not going to happen now.
Well, Coach, I didn't mean to cut you off, but in the society that we have right now, isn't it almost that we got to have these things happen right now because ADs get impatient, presidents get impatient, fans get impatient. Gone is the day where you think a guy can get in and hang a clipboard and a whistle around his neck for 20 years and watch them literally build a program. It's like microwave. Everything has to happen right now. Is that somewhat of a challenge and pressure?
Yes, it's a challenge, and it's definitely a pressure. But that is why we take this job, you know. If it wasn't for that pressure, we wouldn't have this challenge.
Uh-huh.
You know, we feel good about what we put, you know, what we bring to the table, and I know that we're going to have a championship in the near future.
Okay, that sounds great. Now, we talked about some of the guys that they brought in from the offensive side of the ball. Give us some background on some of the young men that we have that's going to be representing the defensive side.
Okay, defensive side of the ball, we got a transfer in, a middle linebacker. Linebacker was one of the positions that we had to, you know, deepen up. So we brought a transfer in from Ball State, Shamon Reese. We also brought a JC linebacker in, Taquan Smith. And both of those guys were extremely fast and good.
Okay.
I think both of those guys fit what we do defensively. And I'm looking definitely excited about what we bring to the table.
Okay.
We also got two young corners. Both of them is 6'1", both of them 10'6" meters. On what we're doing at that position, we're lengthening our corners, and we're also getting fast at that position.
Yes, sir.
So now we're getting bigger corners so we can deal with those bigger wide receivers.
So will you be able to influx your will, what you like to do defensively now that's coming in?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. We're also signing another extended defensive back from NEO.
Mm-hmm.
Darius Hawkins. Nickel guy, cover guy, blitz guy, those are the type of guys we need in order for us to make my job and make this defensive scheme work.
Yes, sir. Now, I've been vocal and critical about we have that guy that we want. We talked about those 3, 4, 5s. Do we have a plan B in the event you can't get that guy that makes your plan work? Do you have a base defense that you like to lean on?
Yes. And, of course, we have a base defense that if we don't get the guy that we know that we need in order for us to execute some of the defensive calls that are necessary, then, of course, we got schemes that we can cover those guys up and we make the offensive coordinator find them.
Mm-hmm.
If they can't find them, then that's good for us and bad on them.
Yes, sir.
But, I want to be able to be strong all over so I can be able to do a lot of things on defense. And now we won't become predictable.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
And that's what I'm trying to get to.
Yes, sir. Now, once again, the game is won and lost in those trenches.
Yes.
I call them the big uglies in a nice way. The guys up front, they don't have to necessarily be the fastest, but they have strength, you know. And sometimes a squatty body would be just what you need.
Yes.
What and how do you assess a player that would fit what a Coach Miller needs to be effective?
And there, what I need him to be able to do is, first of all, be aggressive at the point of attack. I need him to get off the ball. Okay, if you're a shade, I need you to get off the ball and try to create a duck. But if you're not, if you're a free tech, I need you to be fast enough and strong enough to be able to play the run. And then at the same time, keep pressure on the quarterback. You know, so we ask him for our three tech to be a dual player. We ask you to be strong and ask you to be fast. We ask you to stop the run, and we also ask you to put pressure on the quarterback. So those guys, you know, they deal with them. You're looking for them to be different. You're looking for them to be about 75, 280 pounds that can move. You know, so that's what we're looking for.
Okay, and I just call it just a dog.
Yes, that's exactly what they are, dogs.
Yeah. Well, Coach, look, I know that they said spring practice will begin on March 25th. We'll be out there.
looking to shake and bake. Now, I do want to ask you this. Now, it might have been because of personnel. You guys didn't blitz a lot.
Well, what we call the cover-up, we did what we call zone pressure.
Okay.
You know, we blitzed, but we played zone behind. But this year, I wanted to get a little bit more into what my package. And in order for us to do that, we got to get guys in that can cover one-on-one. So those are the moves that we was trying to make. So now we ain't going to just be a zone blitz. We're going to be a man blitz, be a zone blitz. Can't nobody, you know, we'll be able to do whatever we need to do in time of need, you know, instead of being, okay, I don't want to put this guy on the holler, but that guy's going to be able to handle it. So now we can get the blitzes and guys do what we want to send.
Okay, Coach Henry Miller, man, it's definitely a joy to have you on here. I want to let you know, just like we let all the other coaches know, you're welcome here at any time. We like keeping people informed, and as you see, I do know a little bit about football.
Yes, I know a lot about football.
I know enough to keep me in trouble, right?
Right.
But look, man, we're glad that you guys are here working on building a program. And I tell people all the time, a team is okay, but I'd rather have a program.
Exactly. And that's exactly what we're trying to build here. We got experience from some of the best coaches we want on this level. We know what, you know, we know what we're doing and how to do it. So, you know, we just putting the pieces together, and we're going to win.
Okay, okay. That sounds inviting, sir. Once again, welcome to the Hill, and know that you're welcome here anytime. We are going to take us another break. They started introducing some of the coaches right here, but to be honest with you, Coach, we came for the football. It's traditionally a football time of year, and we're going to hold it at that end. We're going to let them do whatever they need to do on that. But appreciate you having me, man, and look forward to talking to you real soon. Okay?
Thank you, and I'm glad to be here.
All right. Coach Henry Miller, defensive coordinator for the Prairie A&M University Panthers. We are going to take us a break, and we'll come right back.
Education and improvements in schools. Make elementary school teaching a more rewarding career than ever. A career that high school and college students should certainly consider. Education. Your future.
To fight. All Texans must find the courage to fight child abuse.
Learn the signs and symptoms and report suspected abuse to appropriate authorities.
Learn and know these warning signs.
A child who undergoes changes in behavior, appetite, or routine. Watch for unexplained injuries, a change in academic performance, or loss of interest by a child with regular activity.
Trust your instincts. If you suspect something, do something.
If you believe a child is in an abusive situation, please call the Texas Abuse Hotline at 1-800-252-5400.
Be the one with courage. To find your local Children's Advocacy Center, visit onewithcourage.org.
On behalf of children, thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
And welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. This is the Radio Guy, Dr. Mike Prince, live from the Prairie View A&M University Nursing Center. They're doing some introductions of coaches right now. So what we're going to do is hear from the voice of the Texas Southern Tigers, Valerie Hale ChattaBox. He had a little round and round earlier today leading up for this weekend's big contest between the Panthers and the Tigers. We'll now switch over to hear what ChattaBox has to say, and we'll be right back.
How you doing, ladies? Of course, this is the Radio Guy, the Dr. Mike Prince, and you know it is always a wonderful time when we get a chance to talk with my brother, my friend, and we're going to say a good rival partner. Larry ChattaBox here, the voice, the Texas Southern Tigers. How you doing today, my man?
Good morning to you, brother. How are you?
Man, you know what? I'm blessed and highly favored. Well, I got to ask this question. Why is it every time we get ready to do something, man, I start hearing all that typing and texting stuff going on in the background? What's up with all that, man?
Because I stay working, Prince. I can't sit up under a shade tree like you do down there in Prairie View and just let the sun hit my face and the leaves blow. I got to work down here, man.
You got to work down and say it ain't easy, Judge. It ain't easy, but somebody got to do it, right?
Right.
Well, look here, man. It is a big week. We We got National Signing Day this week. We got Prairie View Texas Southern rival game this week. Prairie View basketball teams, men and women, in good position as far as this backstretch go for the basketball regular season. Of course, the tournament is a whole different beast. What's the atmosphere like, man, coming up for this weekend down in Houston, Texas?
Oh, the atmosphere is great. The city is a buzz. Everyone's excited. They're calling for tickets. Prairie View folk calling for tickets. They want to make sure they're inside the H&P Arena, unlike how Prairie View does when we come down there. We don't hide the tickets. We divide them, buddy.
We don't hide. We divide. Well,
that's right.
I have nothing to do with the administrative part. I want to talk about the actual play.
Well, not necessarily, because I heard you made a phone call or two. But we'll get into that later. You are the Vito Corleone Prairie View.
So I'm going to make you an offer you cannot refuse. So
anytime anybody has a problem, it goes straight to Mike Prince.
Well, some would agree to disagree with that, but I'll take it for what it's worth. With that being said, man, look, there's been an anti-Reed sighting here over the past few weeks. Is there any backstory to that or what's going on or what's his status like as we speak?
He's still working through an injury at this moment. He's still being reevaluated by the doctors. Just want to make sure that he's in the best shape for himself.
Gotcha.
You have to look out for the student athlete. Sure, it's great to throw him out there, but you just want to make sure that he's going to be okay for himself later on down the line.
Okay.
And I think that's a class move by the university, class move by the doctors that we have for Baylor. But we're just letting everything, make sure everything is healed and ready to go.
Absolutely. So it's safe to assume that there will be another no-show for Reed this weekend as the Panthers and the Tigers hit the hardwood.
The doctors are reevaluating him at the moment. Not sure what will happen after that, but the medical professionals, along with the coaching staff, are looking into that situation right now.
Boy, you sure trying to be politically correct, aren't you?
No, because you want the truth, Brent. If you don't want the truth, don't call.
You don't want the truth because you can't handle the truth.
I just send you the voice if you don't want the truth. Ask Carlos Brown about the truth.
You know, I got to ask this question, man. Now, the buzz in the air is this, that, you know, they said we got lucky the first time we met you guys. And, okay, I'll take
it.
Okay.
You did get lucky.
Now, I'm going to ask you a legitimate question. Are you one of those that are whispering that Prairie View has yet to be tested?
Well, Prairie View had a hell of a battle the other night with Luke Jack City.
Yes, sir.
Won by two. Well, if Texas Southern would have won, made their free throws, we missed 18 free throws, and we lost by six.
Okay, so there you go. So with
anyone listening within the sound of my voice, you already know what the deal is.
That you're a lousy free throw shooting team.
Okay.
You know, why I got to hear these ifs, man? Why, okay, we barely won by two. Okay, if we won by half a point, we won. When you do a 100-yard sprint, if I win by 1/100th of a second, do you think I care that I won by 1/100th of a second as long as I win?
You're right.
Okay, then. So with that being said, you have been the voice now. You're working on your 19th season or 20th season, Chatter?
We're going on 20.
Going on 20.
If I survive this season, hitting in the football will be my 20th season of broadcast.
Well, you know what, man? You know I love you like a fat kid loves candy, and appreciate what you do and how you do. But I want to hear that Houston Symphony crank up on Saturday night after they start playing that PV fight song. With that
well, I don't think you hear that because Johnny Jones and Coach Janetta Hayes will make sure that that Prairie View crowd will have nothing to cheer about.
They will have nothing to cheer about?
Other than we still got enough drumettes upstairs in the concession stand for y'all to buy.
Oh, man. Now, look, you asked me a question the other day, man, and I want to ask you this question right here. When it comes down to SWAC play, whether it's football, basketball tiddlywinks. What does the SWAC mean to you personally?
SWAC, what does the SWAC mean to me personally? I think it's got a deep, rich heritage with some very talented players, great coaches. It's just a family atmosphere to me. I feel like it's a really big family atmosphere. And when, you know, when I'm dealing with the SWAC and when I'm out there on the road, I really take things to heart because those are moments that you can't get back. And the people that you run across that make a difference in your life, whether it's somebody in Mississippi or whether it's somebody in Alabama or whether it's Sidney Jackson at Alabama A&M, or whether it's different people, they really make a difference in your life, and then you become attached. And when you come to that particular place, oh, yeah, I know Mike Burns is here, or I know Mike Prince is down here in Prairie View, or I know that Chris Powers is down there at Southern, different things like that. When you think about that, you think of Mama Jaguar, gone but not forgotten. So those are memories that you share. You think about all the time.
Absolutely, man. It is one big fan. We have fun ribbing on each other. And sometimes people be listening. They think we be upset with each other, but we talk all the time. This is my brother from another mother. Even though he's in the maroon and gray, I'm in thy purple and gold. We have a good time. And one thing about it, we love each other. We respect each other. But you know y'all going down this weekend, right?
Nope. All contract, my friend.
Hey, you guys got some kids you're signing on football this week as well.
Yes, we'll have the signing day at the field house. We're not going to the nursing center. We'll be at the Dooley Field House where it all begins with the televisions and the couches, and we'll be right there, and all the action will be covered through the Maroon and Gray Radio Network as they come in, and we'll talk with coaches and things of that nature. Get the word out to the Tiger Nation as we load up to get ready for this 2019 SWAC football season.
Now, I heard you throw that shot. Y'all don't have a nursing center. That's why you're not meeting at a nursing center. But I do have the clearance to be down in Houston, right? I got the clearance from you, Mr. Godfather, that I can be.
Anytime you come across a bridge and they say an American gangster, you got to make a phone call.
Look at ChattaBox, man. You know it's always a blast. Prairie View, you know I'm going to be riding with them. I think we'll come out on top on both sides of the ball, women and men. How can people get in contact and hear some of the work that you're producing daily for Maroon and Gray Nation?
They can go to Spreaker.com, click on the ChattaBox podcast, or click on the Maroon and Gray Radio Network, and all the stuff is right there for their listening pleasure. And we just try to keep up with it and keep it going. Different inside interviews, also some great work that our students are doing. So I'm really excited about this whole situation that we have going here at Texas Southern. And one of the things about it, you and I know, we just try to teach the youth so they can continue to keep everything going.
All right, man. Look, we're going to keep things going. Hey, keep a seat for me this weekend.
You know, walk in front of the band.
Hey, baby.
I don't care what you do.
Well, look here. I told you what's going to happen. I'm going to walk in front of the ocean of soul, and when I start walking in front of the ocean of soul, they're going to start playing the swamp that PV is known for. Do you hear what I'm saying?
The swamp.
The swamp. Yeah, check it out. Google it. And when you hear it, you're going to be like, that's what they call that thing? And when you hear it, you better look over your shoulder, baby, because here we come. Here we come. The swamp, baby. We're going to come down there and flood Houston out. You better hear me. Talking about an ocean of soul.
It's 80 degrees because the swamp ain't going to rise too much.
Hey, baby, but you know what? At 80 degrees, the temperature is just right for a storm to come, and it's marching in your way.
Like I said, Prince, you can't come like a cabbage all head in the rear. You got to bring something to get some.
Hey,
so
baby.
You got to bring it on down to Houston, Texas.
Hey, baby, we're going to bring it and bring it back up to the hill where we're going to sit on the throne and look down low to those peasants we call tigers.
As a matter of fact, bring your lunch. Go to your freezer, put in a soda water in your freezer and freeze it real good. Like old school and bring it on down for the trip because you're going to need it.
Yes, sir. Hey, you know what? I'm going to come hungry and thirsty, baby. Not only are we going to have some tiger on the grill, we're going to grab some of them boudin balls, some old French's, as a snack and a treat on the way back with those two
girls. You're not welcome in that parking lot. I already got it, but I already got the notices out and everything.
That's all right. I'll be incognito, baby, and we're going to make it happen.
And we're going to go in there with your sunshade. I will have those boudin balls waiting on you. Don't worry about it.
You got me? Well, look here, man. We going to have us a grand old time. If you've never experienced Prairie View and Texas Southern in anything, you're missing out. I don't care what they say about Michigan and Ohio. I don't care what they say about USC and UCLA. If you hadn't experienced a Prairie View Texas Southern Showdown, you will miss it. I don't care what the records are. I don't care who's on top, who's on the bottom. They kick all that to the side, and it's Katie bar the door. My brother, hold it down till I see you.
Go on.
He is the Chatterbox, the voice of the Texas Southern Tigers. I am the radio guy,
the doctor,
Mike Prince. And until the next time, you guys be blessed. We'll see you on the other side.
And, of course, ladies and gentlemen, that was Mr. Chatterbox himself. Chatterbox was giving us a little, I guess, entertainment value, if you would, as we're talking about the Texas Southern Prairie View game coming up this weekend. We're going to take a quick break. We have been joined by Athletic Director Mr. Fred Watson. We'll take a quick break. We'll be right back.
This is Patricia Bear, President of JZE Building Administration. We specialize in full roof replacement and roof leaks. We assist homeowners with filing insurance claims and help you with the full process from start to finish. We are a complete remodeling and rehab company for commercial and residential. We do drywall, electrical, plumbing, HVAC, flooring, fencing, paint, framing, and much more. We can handle any job, small or large. Contact information is 832-319-8477, JZE Building and Restoration.
And welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. We are live from the Nursing Center at Prairie View A&M University in Houston, Texas area. We are now joined by Athletic Director Fred Washington. Sir, how you doing? Welcome to the show.
Hey, I'm doing well. Thank you for having me. It's a pleasure.
Okay, it's a pleasure to have you on board. You kind of laid back and relaxed tonight, man. All these new signees. You're not excited?
I'm excited, but I'm among the PV Nation, so why should I be relaxed? I'm right on.
Yes, sir. Big night, an all-inclusive night, and including other sports. Historically, this has been about a football thing, but you guys incorporated all sports. What led to that?
Well, you know, when you really think about it, sure, this is Texas, and the nation celebrates football, but we have 400 athletes, and you know, when you have so many students and so many students doing great things on behalf of this institution, you know, why not just recognize and celebrate all of them? All of them are entitled to be recognized for the accomplishment of signing up with any D1 institution to celebrate and push forward in their career goals.
Yes, sir. Now, the last time we got together, man, it was a 6-game winning streak. Now it's a 10-game winning streak. And I told you last time I was going to have to call you Mr. Midas Touch, man. Prairie View is holding on their own record right now. Since 1962, have they gone 10-0.
Yeah.
And 1961, 12-0.
Right.
You got to be excited about this.
I'm excited, but I'm always cautiously apprehensive because just like we won – you know, the first 10 in the top half of the schedule, we got another half of the schedule that we have to go through. And you know, young people get to believe that, you know, you just got to show up sometimes. And it's more than just showing up. You know, as we have had on our men's side such an amazing start to our career, you know, Mike, that everybody that steps on that hardwood against us going forward is going to come in prepared to give it everything that they got. They're not going to leave anything in the locker room. Anything on the floor at the end of the game, and so our student athletes, you know, they've shown that they have the ability to beat every team in this conference in the first half. Now they have to go out and maintain that momentum and represent the Hill the way that they have so far.
Yes, sir. And it all begins on Saturday.
It all begins on Saturday. But I don't want to just talk about the men. The women have had a very good start as well. You know, we had a new coach come in, and if you watch the team play, you see they've put quarters together, but they've only put together just a few complete games. Mm-hmm. And when they put together a complete game, you've seen pretty much what they're capable of. And so if they're able to string together a couple of complete games together, we're excited about what both our men and women's teams have the opportunity to do going forward.
Yes, sir. They had me singing on the episode this morning. It's the most wonderful time of year. You got basketball, swinging in the baseball, softball.
Yeah. Yeah.
And everything is just gelling together right now.
Yeah, it's spring again.
Yeah, it is spring again. Yeah. Pretty soon these youngsters are gonna be stepping. I don't step no more, brother.
You walk. I just watch. I don't even do no walking moves. I'm just a spectator there.
Yeah. We've aged gracefully, and we lead it to the youngsters. Now, with everything that's coming up, there's been some moves going on, sir. And they said the cat is out the bag right now. Are you at liberty to talk about that, or are you just going to let it just kind of ride?
We got a lot of cats in the bag, so but I don't know which one got out.
Part of your I guess your sports stats team has relocated.
No, yeah, and that you know, we lost Dwayne Lewis. Went to Arkansas Pine Bluff, but let me say that Melvin Hines, who's the athletic director over there, you know, he handled that whole thing in a first-class manner. Melvin contacted me before he contacted Dwayne. You know, this has been a conversation that's been going on for several months. So there wasn't any secrets, anything, and I think it was a great opportunity for Dwayne. I'm so excited and so happy for him. He did a good job for Panther Sports, and there was, you know, there's nothing wrong with identifying an opportunity that you think is best for you and your family. Arkansas Pine Bluff right now was able to offer him something that Prairie wasn't. So I wish him well. I look forward to Arkansas Pine Bluff and that program doing some good things. He did what we asked him to do. We asked him to give us the time to adjust and prepare and get the staff geared up to do what's necessary to carry the PV Nation forward in our sports program and communication, and he did that for us. So I want to thank him in his transition.
Now, with that, it's just like coaching. You know, a recruit leaves, his eligibility is up. You got a whiteboard. Who's on your whiteboard?
We've been contacted really by a lot of people. It's just as you talk about coaching, when a coach leaves, you get all of the coaches from all around America talking about, I'm your next guy or girl, whichever the case may be. In this situation, you know, we have Latanya Thurston, who's on deck. You know, she was his assistant. I believe if you look at my time, Mike, with our program, with our institution, when you have good people, you give them a chance to show you what they can do for you, whether they are or are not able, you know, to carry the mantle forward. So right now she's doing that for us. Obviously, we have to build a team, whether that's her leading or whether that's somebody else leading. You know, the jury's still out. But we're going to build a team that we think can provide the packages and the things that we need to do. But, you know, she's been a part of that group that's done a pretty good job of communicating, and we're going to try to make it work with what we got right now.
Okay, we're talking right now with Athletic Director Fred Washington. Mr. Midas, that's all I can think of, man. It was just everything fits like a glove. Maybe it's the Michael Jackson glove. Is that what it is?
You know what? My first record was a Michael Jackson record, so I'll take that Dancing Machine. If you want to, I did all of that. But like I said, I don't do any of those things no more, so I'm not going to show y'all. But yeah, I did all of those things. The Dancing Machine. My daddy bought me that. What it was, 45.
Yes, sir.
Dancing Machine.
I don't think people know what 45 is. 78 and 33.
Old little record.
Yes,
in my room. That was my first album, Michael Jackson.
Okay, that's all right, man. Now, look, Fred, I got to ask you this. I'm sorry, Mr. Washington.
It's Fred.
we got the schedule for football. Now, going back to football.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Is this what you see is what you get, or is there room for more?
No, there's definitely room for more. So right now, Mike, what we were able to release today is a 10-game schedule. You know, when we started just about 6 weeks ago, we only had 9 games on the book, so we went out and secured a 10th game to make sure we got the minimum package that we wanted to put out on the floor, and then we have 2 additional contracts out there. The slate that I'm trying to put together is a regional slate.
Mm-hmm.
If both of the other 2 games come through, which one of them we're pretty certain we're just waiting on the paperwork, you know, we have the opportunity to have 6 home games on campus this year, 2 games in Houston, so 8 of our 12 game schedule will be, you know, basically in the city of Houston or on our campus from the Dallas game. So 9 of the 12 games, the Panther Nation can see the Panthers play with just a simple commute right up and down the road. That's what we're trying to put together, and put together a regional schedule going forward. But right now we have four home games on our schedule, two games in Houston to make six, and then the four road games, one of them being the Savior Classic in Dallas.
Very good, very good. Now, for those, you know, we're audio, so we're not showing.
Sure.
Just the non-conference, they pretty much know who the regular conference, who would your non-conference contest be?
Non-conference contest, so we have, seven conference contests.
Mm-hmm.
Then we have University of Houston in Houston, Nicholls State.
At home.
At home, and then we have Virginia Lynchburg, which is a program out of Virginia. Those are the three non-conference opponents that we have right now to bring us to 10 games, and then we have two additional non-conference contests that we had. The tough thing with getting the schedule together this year, Mike, is the schedule that was built when I transitioned over,
mm-hmm.
we really only had a lot of open dates starting in October and then to November. And as you know, as a sports guy, it's very hard at this late juncture to be coordinating for 2019 games in November. It was not a lot of opponents out there. I was very fortunate that through some of our partnerships within the conference and then going to the NCAA convention last week to find these two other opportunities. It wasn't until last week that we found these two other opportunities. One of them jumped on us right away, and the other is still doing some negotiating and trying to, you know, they had us over a barrel at first, and now they're finding out we have an 11th game, so they're being a little more flexible.
There you go.
To get them in.
There you go. Now, without giving up the team, mm-hmm. are you at liberty to give what conferences we're talking to?
Not at this juncture. I'm not ready to do it because normally I would, but I was over there just a few minutes ago with our Panther backers, and the Panther backers showed me a list that they have every football recruit on our board. They have it on a sheet of paper because they're following us and researching us that close. So if I give you a little information, somebody out there is going to be able to put together because the schedules for most teams are available online.
Mm-hmm.
So if you know the conference, all you got to do is go and look at who don't have no games on the dates that we are needing the game, and you'll be able to.
Well, not necessarily. We just had a conference. It's coming out in a couple of weeks anyway, though.
Yeah, it's out there. It'll be easy to piece together. Now that I've learned the gridiron system and all those things, you know, if you give me two or three pieces of information, I can tell you who you are.
Well, that's good investigation, though.
Yeah,
that's good investigational skill.
It is, but I got you. But my concern, my problem is right now we're not the only team out there looking for games.
Mm-hmm.
And somebody who finds out another team that is interested and open for that date may come out and offer a better opportunity.
Kind of sweep the world from
trying to get from out. So until I got that contract in hand, it's mum's the word.
Just give me one of them 3 a.m. texts.
Yeah, coach don't even know who we talk about. I'm not letting it out until we know.
Well, and that's very much understood. A lot of moving parts going on right now. As you said, over 400 student athletes that you're responsible for. And parts are moving at all times, sometimes in different directions,
yeah.
And to get them back on course. Talk about the season ticket opportunity for those that are listening right
now. Sure. Season ticket renewals start today. So we were very blessed to see renewals. You know, people kicked right off this morning. We had two or three renewals, you know, within the first hour. So the fans are excited to come in and to be able to get these packages. We've obviously started a lot earlier. We're trying to be a better service provider for our fans and supporters, so we're going to roll those things forward and give people the time and opportunity to do things. You know, when you do things late in this world, I'm a family man, you're a family man, it's a difference in my household when you start asking me to do things after my family went on vacation or when my kids are getting ready to go back to school. So if you put some of those things earlier out there and give me an opportunity, you know, I can get a lot more done. So the renewal period started today. We'll be in what we call the pure renewal period for 2 weeks. So for this first 2 weeks, only someone who was a season pass holder last year can purchase their season pass. Anything that we have in our inventory that was not sold or owned by someone else last year, you can buy. So if you had two tickets, you can renew your tickets, plus you can buy other things. You're not just restricted to that.
So what about if you wanted to get tickets in a consecutive row?
If they were not owned by another season pass holder, you can do that. But if you were in seat 1 and 2,
mm-hmm.
and seat 3 and 4 were vacant, or sold game to game last year, you can buy seat 3 and 4.
Okay.
Seat 3 and 4 was held by another season pass holder until they decide to release those seats. We can't do that.
Okay. Very good.
So that renewal period, as I said, is for 2 weeks. At the end of that 2 weeks, we're not releasing the seats that other season pass holders had, but everything else will be open public so that anyone who wants to purchase season pass can do that. But after March 5th, which is 1 month from today, after March 5th, if you have not renewed and it was occupied last year, you can buy those seats.
Okay.
After March
5th, if you were a season ticket holder, you have not renewed, or you still at risk of keeping your seat or losing your seat.
March 5th, if someone wants your seat,
it's open.
They can buy it.
You heard that, baby, right? You got to March 5th. Talking to my wife over here.
I know. She came and introduced herself over there to me. It was
yes,
sir. To meet her. I don't think I've met her before.
You never met my wife, man?
I don't think I had. I didn't remember.
Well, she was kicking around the yard when we was up there, so.
Well, then I don't know if I haven't met her. I didn't recognize her today.
Well, we're going to see because she's age graceful. That's well.
Okay.
Yes,
was she in Club Chic or one of them organizations?
She was an IZ.
Okay.
Interesting data.
Okay.
Yes, sir. And she's been a good helpmate, a solid helpmate. All right. Well, man, it's been solid having you on board. As always, we want to give you a final closing thought with the PV Nation, man.
Well, you know, I've been talking to the athletic team, the staff, and our students, and I've been using this military phrase since we did the military thing the other day. I've been sharing this thing that my military leader shared with me, is that a rising tide lifts all boats. All right, and the tide is rising for Panther Sports, and everybody who wants to take this ride and ride with us, we're going to all make it to the top together. That was the first part of the lesson that I learned, and I thought that was all of it. I learned that when I was a second lieutenant. When I became a captain, my lieutenant colonel taught me the second half of that parable or lesson, if you will. And he said that, you know, sometimes when the tide is rising, some things are anchored down. And if you're anchored down, you're going to sink. It ain't going to stop the tide. It's still going to rise, and those that are ready to go will make it to the top. But if you anchor down, not too much we can do to help you. The Prairie View Panther pride and the tide is rising for us. You can see. I know you're on the air right now, Mike, and not getting to hear everything that these coaches are saying.
Mm-hmm.
But what they're saying and what you'll hear about later is that student athletes are choosing Prairie View right now. They could go anywhere in the nation.
Absolutely,
they can go anywhere in the nation, and they are choosing to come to Prairie View. Our tide is rising, and the best for us is still yet to come.
Because Prairie View is still producing productive people.
All
right.
God bless you guys.
God bless you, sir. Thank you so much, Brother Fred Washington. We are going to take us a break, and we'll come back with more from the Prairie View A&M University Nursing Center. I am the radio guy, Dr. Mike Prince. Keep it where you got it, and we will be right back.
Hey, my name is Nikki Antwine, owner of Salon and Spa out in Missouri City, Texas. I want to shout out to my son, Andre Lewis, who is the receiver over at PV University. And I just want to say I love listening to Mike Prince on the Open Mic Broadcast Network.
How you doing? It's the radio guy, the Dr. Mike Prince, reminding you that you're listening to the Open Mic Broadcast Network. We're taking a break from our live coverage right now. However, we'd like to remind you that we bring a lot more to the table than you may be aware of. Did you know about Our Journey Alive? It's a weekly talk show that features three dynamic women sharing their overcoming of domestic abuse and much, much more. You can listen to Sophia and the Gang each and every week right here at the Open Mic Broadcast Network. What about Prairie View United, also known as PVU? It's giving you up-to-date information going on throughout the city limits of Prairie View, Texas, and Waller County, Texas. Of course, there is the sports report that is breaking news of the world of athletics and the daily Mike Prince coverage of the Mike Prince Show right here at the Open Mic Broadcast Network. And for those who seek spiritual guidance, we even offer Sunday Morning Live, live broadcast of the Temple of Refuge Ministries, brought to you each and every week right here on the Open Mic Broadcast Network. So be sure to check out what you've been missing by visiting the website at obnradio.com, or you can dial 605-477-5066. And for those who happen to be within the Prairie View community, you can always check us out at 879 FM, the station designed with you in mind, serving the community through faith and athletics, the Open Mic Broadcast Network.
And welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. We are live here from Prairie View A&M University Athletic Banquet Signing Day. Football was the topic, but it's baseball season. And I have with me head baseball coach Auntwan Riggins. How you doing, sir?
I'm doing fine. How you
doing? There you go.
There you go.
There you go again. What's going on, coach?
Not much, man. But you were straight up with me. I'm a boy, Damon.
Okay. I'm trying not to talk loud.
No, it's okay. Okay. It's okay. This is the live radio section over here.
We
good.
Okay.
You got baseball season coming up here, man. It's hitting real quick. You ready?
Yes, sir.
Okay. I heard you signed a couple of guys from around the way in that Region 17, District 17, I'm sorry, baseball on their way of Magnolia West. Some good baseball off in that area. Bring us up to speed on what you got representing for 19.
First of all, thanks for having me. 2019 season is on the way. We start next weekend, so I'm looking forward to that. And we open up at DeAndre Dawson Classics in New Orleans, so it's always good to be around the Hawks. I signed three guys early, 2019, D'Angelo, Hannah Hoxley, Little Winfield, signed a kid all the way around. Offensively and defensively, with potential to have pop. I'm looking for him to come in and push some kids, and possibly he may start. This other kid is Brayden Johnson, out of Longview, Texas. This kid's power speed, 6'6 running, high IQ guy. So I'm looking for him to come in and push the outfielders.
Okay.
High IQ. Usually in baseball, you hardly ever hear anybody say about that IQ. I think it's a 6'2". I think that's a tool they need to start putting in.
Some baseball knowledge can actually make up for what you may lack in the other areas, because a lot of people don't understand what made Lou Brock such a prolific baseball stealer. Wasn't that he was so fast, but his ability to read the pitches and pick up on habits to get advanced. I had to do an old swag St. Louis Cardinal guy.
Most definitely, because, you can have all the speed in the world, don't steal bases. If you're not a good base stealer, you're a base runner. So I understand that. But this guy here is amazing. He's got talking baseball with him. And they an hour visit turned out to be about 3 hours, because just sitting there just talking baseball, and it was great.
Okay, well, we're talking right now with Coach Auntwan Riggins. They're getting ready for the MLB Classic down in the Big Easy. This will be your fourth year dealing with this, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay,
yes, sir.
And it seemed like they always want to match us up against Auntwan. What's up with that?
It's because the other coaches from outside don't want to play us until the season starts, so I'm good with it.
You good with it like
yeah,
that?
Baseball is baseball.
Okay, now look, the big to-do has been uniform, and with this new Adidas setup, what we going to look like on the diamond?
Oh, man, we're going to look good and play good.
Okay.
I think we did a good job with the uniform. We got a white, we got a gray.
Uh-huh.
We got some different offsets with white and gray and purple and gold. So
purple and gold.
Yes.
Did you get rid of the Astro look?
Yes. Yes, I did. going out there looking like the quality baseball team.
Okay. Well, that is good. Well, look, man, it is always good to have spot now. We're on live on the radio.
Yes, sir.
You haven't responded to my SWAT baseball coach's request.
No, I haven't. I apologize for it. I'm more welcome to do anything you need me to do, brother.
Okay, man. Okay, Coach Antoine, really, we're going to give you final thoughts and comments for the listening audience right now.
Oh, no, man. I'm very excited about the 2019 season. You know, we got some quality kids in, some quality pitching, some guys that we moved around on the diamond last year. So I'm looking forward to us coming in and playing some quality baseball. I think the kids now, you know, we went through a rough season last year. And now I think the guys are gelling, are doing whatever we need to do to win games. The small things that we didn't really, that guys really didn't think to focus on last year, that's all we did all fall. And I'm so excited to see what these guys can do come next weekend.
Well, see, now you can start speaking up a little bit now that they got started bumping the music up on you right now. But look, Coach, we're looking forward to it. Your first home sighting, if I'm not mistaken, remembering the schedule, is going to be against Texas A&M. Not home, but, you know, back in Texas.
Yeah, back in Texas.
Yeah.
It'll be Texas A&M on
the Wednesday after the ninth or something, not the ninth, whatever that Wednesday, the next Wednesday. Something like that. I know.
21st. I think it's the 21st. No, the 20th.
Yeah, we know it's going to be a Wednesday in February.
Wednesday following the open weekend.
Right. Yes, sir. So, look, man, we're looking forward to that. Baseball back on the hill. We'll start talking pitchers and depth after a while. Going out, good turnout here tonight. Good to see you out here tonight, man. We are going to take us a quick break, and we'll come back with more of our live show right here from Houston, Texas. I am the radio guy, Dr. Mike Krentz. We're going to pause for the calls, and we'll be right back.
Do you know what's up with Ryan? He's been acting weird, and he's not hanging out anymore. He borrowed money from me and still hasn't paid it back. His girlfriend broke up with him a couple weeks ago. Said he was more into his sports app than her. He may be addicted to fantasy sports. We need to get him some help.
Sports betting and fantasy sports can have serious consequences. Know somebody with a gambling problem? Get free and confidential help. Call 1-877-MY-LIMIT. That's 1-877-695-4648. Or go online to opgr.org. This message brought to you by Lane County Public Health and EARS.
Chris, can you put the video game controller down for a second?
I can talk and play. Oh, I'm totally annihilating this punk kid in Nebraska.
I just feel like you're not acting like a grown-up in our relationship.
M2!
Well, you know, you still ride your skateboard to work, there's the comic book collection, the race car bed.
Look, I'm young at heart, but I put money into my 401k every paycheck. I picked up a few savings tips at feedthepig.org. I have control over my financial life now, and that feels pretty grown up.
I put away a few bucks, feel like a million bucks. Putting some money from every paycheck into a savings account or contributing to your 401k can make a big difference later. For free ideas and easy tips on ways to save, go to feedthepig.org. That's feedthepig.org.
So, I better look like a grown-up to you now.
Well, except for the footy pajamas, I'd have to agree.
This message brought to you by the American Institute of Certified Public Accountants and the Ad Council.
One voice. It can get the point across, but it only carries so far. Add a voice. It's richer, louder, but that has limits too. Add a third voice. It's even more powerful. Add another, and many, many more. And we are stronger than ever. That's the power of a community coalition. They help community groups, faith groups, civic organizations, PTAs, employers, and many others in your community organize their resources and focus them where they're needed most, like fighting to keep kids away from drugs. Ask a group that you belong to if they should belong to a community coalition. It's easy to get involved. Visit helpyourcommunity.org and they'll tell you exactly how your group can help. That's helpyourcommunity.org, because you get more. Brought to you by the Office of National Drug Control Policy and the Ad Council.
Broadcasters come into our lives on radio and TV, bringing us information and entertainment. Broadcasters are there for us, but who is there for them when they fall on hard times? The Broadcasters Foundation of America provides financial assistance to broadcasters in acute need due to a critical illness, accident, or other serious misfortune. If you know of a broadcaster on the air or behind the scenes who may need our help, please share our message. Visit broadcastersfoundation.org.
Be the one with courage to fight child abuse.
All Texans must find the courage to fight child abuse.
Learn the signs and symptoms and report suspected abuse to appropriate authorities.
Learn and know these warning signs.
A child who undergoes changes in behavior, appetite, or routine. Watch for unexplained injuries, a change in academic performance, or loss of interest by a child in regular activity.
Trust your instincts. If you suspect something, do something.
If you believe a child is in an abusive situation, please call the Texas Abuse Hotline at 1-800-252-5400.
Be the one with courage. To find your local Children's Advocacy Center, visit onewithcourage.org.
On behalf of children, thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
You want answers?
I think I'm entitled.
You want answers?
I want the truth.
You can't handle the truth.
I have a greater responsibility than you can possibly fathom. You want me on that wall. You need me on that wall.
Listen to the Mike Prince Show weekday on the Open Mic Broadcast Network.
And welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Mike Grant here with you as we are just about ready to wrap up our coverage here from the National Signing Day here in Houston, Texas. On behalf of the Prairie View A&M University Panthers, it has been a packed night of information and people from all over as we have been able to catch up with a lot of people. And, as we say, make up some time for lost ground. We have spoken with offensive coordinator Coach Ted White. We've spoken with the head coach, the Ghost, Eric Dooley. We spoke with Henry Miller, defensive coordinator. We heard from Miss Sandy Pugh, who's actually in the house on tonight. We heard from Larry, the ChattaBox Hale. We also heard from athletic director, Mr. Fred Washington, and baseball coach Auntwan Riggins. We want to thank those who have made today's show possible. The Prairie View Athletic Club, located in Prairie View, Texas, serving student athletes since 1986. That number to join for information is 936-857-5817. We also want to thank JZE Building and Restoration, located in the Cypress area. Excellent job as far as remodeling and everything goes. Just did a bumper job on my home. Their number is 832-319-8477. Of course, attorney Lee Van Richardson, located in the Hempstead, Texas area, 1047 Austin Street in Hempstead, to be exact. His phone number is 979-826-8008. We have got a lot of things covered, and thanking you all so much for your joining in with us on today for the coverage going on. They're wrapping up right now, looking at the players of signing in and taking on. You heard about the schedule that will be taking place. Still working on two games for a possible six home games, which would be a pretty good thing to come in from PV Nation's point of view. The Panthers looking to build and take care of business as this National Signing Day is coming towards a conclusion. We're going to go over a couple of quick notes that we had to make mention on you for tonight. We talked about the big offensive lineman, Mr. Briggs, out of Waxahachie, Texas. And the big one on today was running back Ahmad Anton out of New Orleans. He has committed to Prairie View A&M University Panthers. Shane Lawrence also
big-time quarterback recruit. A lot of hope in brother Jalen Jackson out of the ATL, as he will be coming in ready to get things abroad for PV Nation. The practices will start March 25th, and they'll be ready to get things on the roll. And as always, we appreciate you guys and all that you do and how you've got it done to join us here for tonight's coverage from the Nursing Center at Prairie View A&M University. Remember to listen to the Mike Prince Show each and every day on the Open Mic Broadcast Network starting at 10 a.m. Central Standard Time. I must prepare to exit stage left. We want to thank, once again, ChattaBox, Coach Pugh, Coach Miller, Coach Dooley, Coach White, Coach Riggins, Athletic Director, Mr. Washington, and all of you who have made tonight's show what it was. Until the next time, you guys be blessed, and we'll see you on the other side.